Alhamdulillah, the lines are very straight. Alhamdulillah. Now I'd like you to have a seat, inshallah. Shaykh Zahid is right here. The volunteers.
And it will be two rak'ahs. In the first rak'ah, I will make seven takbirat and then recite the Fatiha and the Surah. In the second, I will make five takbirat and then recite Al Fatiha and the Surah. And then we all should stay to hear the ceremony and the guest speech, inshallah. Straighten your lines. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعين به ونسترشده ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. Dear brothers and sisters, and how you are going to apply it to your future life, and this is what we need to do about Ramadan. These are the courses, the lessons that we have learned in the month of Ramadan. We have fasted for 30 days, long hours, 17 to 16 hours, one of the longest Ramadan that we have fasted for many of us. And we have seen hunger and thirst. But these were done by all of us, by the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, voluntarily, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But we should know that there are people who are not eating, who are fasting, not the month of Ramadan, but every day of the year. Not because they want to fast, because they cannot afford the food. They cannot have food on their tables. And we should remember them. And we should be very aware of these needs. There are people even here around us in Canada who do not have enough food on their tables. And it's only enough to ask the food banks and they will tell you. I know that one bank only, one food bank, served more than 500,000 person a year with food. So there is a need always for this. And we know that the First Nation, some communities of the First Nation even do not have running water here in Canada, drinking water readily available. So when we look at the food and the water, when we look at the hunger and the thirst, we should learn from it two important lessons. One of it is to be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all the bounties that He has given us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran remind us time after time to be thankful to Him. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu kulu min tayyibati ma razaqnakum washkuru lillah. O you who believe, eat from the good food, from the good things that we have provided for you, and be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In kuntum iyyahu ta'budun. If you worship Him, then be thankful to Him. And thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is done not only through prayers, but through deeds, through giving to the needy and the poor, through conservation of food and the drinks. If we look at the leftovers that we throw away, how many people we can feed? Millions and millions. So we should be looking at these leftovers as a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala being thrown away. We should look at every drop of water that we waste as something that Allah gave to us and we throw it away. We should be conserving food and giving it to the needy. We should be conserving water and utilizing it in the best way. Let's all remember that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam one time saw one of his companions making wudu, making ablution, and he was using water excessively. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, "Don't use water too much." And he said to him, "Even when I am making wudu." And the Prophet said to him, "La tusrif walau kunta ala nahri jari." Even if you are taking the water from a running river, do not overuse it. Be mindful that this is a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It has to be used wisely. The second point, when we look at the long hours of fasting, is a very important point that gives us the wisdom and the fairness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In establishing Ramadan, we follow the lunar calendar. And the lunar calendar takes us through the seasons. We do not fast in one season only. In one month only, we are moving through the seasons. We are fasting long, difficult hours, but soon we will be fasting medium hours, enjoyable hours. And soon after that, when we will be fasting in the winter, we will be fasting very short hours, very sweet siyam. And this is the gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His fairness to all of us. If we were following the solar calendar, we will be fasting always long hours or short hours, and it would not be fair to the servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have fasted long hours here. Our brothers in South Africa fast short hours, and it is the winter there. So this is the wisdom and the fairness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What we should leave the month of Ramadan with is the Quran. This is the month of the Quran. This is the month when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the Quran. And this is the month where almost every one of you finished one recitation of the Quran during this month. But should we leave this behind us? Should we leave this course of Quran recitation just for the month of Ramadan? Not at all. It should go with us every day of the year. Every day of the year we should recite at least one page on a daily basis. Can you give Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 15 minutes of your time? If you can, and you can, you should recite one page of the Quran with its interpretation, so you know the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Start your day by reciting the Quran. Listen to the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Start your day by taking guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A page of the Quran recited every day will bring barakah to you, will bring a fresh start to every day of the year. And the friendship that you have established with the Quran in the month of Ramadan will continue for the rest of the year. In the month of Ramadan, many of us who miss a prayer or two did not miss any prayer. They were observant of their prayers. And again, we should continue this noble tradition beyond the month of Ramadan. If we were able to pray every prayers of the five daily prayers, what prevents us beyond the month of Ramadan to pray our regular prayers? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded us to pray at the established times. We are inna salata kanat ala al-mu'minina kitaban mawquta. The prayers are commanded to the believers in its proper time. So we should all make a commitment to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not to miss a prayer beyond the month of Ramadan, to make our daily communication with our Lord, with our Creator, without any interruption. This is the gift of the month of Ramadan. And we have come to our prayers to the mosques, and we should continue this tradition beyond the month of Ramadan. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us about certain group of people who are always going to the mosque. لَا تُلْهِيهِمْ تِجَارَةٌ وَلَا بَيْعٌ عَنْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. Nothing would distract them from the prayers to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No business, no trade will make them stay away from the mosque. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, because of their endeavors, they will be rewarded by Allah a great reward in this life and in the hereafter. These are some of the lessons of the month of Ramadan. The certificates that we have received today is not enough. Usually, if you graduate, they will tell you, this is just the start. You need to practice, you need to work, and we need to practice the teachings of Ramadan. We need to put into practice for all of our lives what we have learned in the month of Ramadan. And this will be the great success, inshaAllah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله. Dear brothers and sisters, today is a day of joy and happiness, a day celebrating, completing the 30 days of Ramadan. But we as Muslims, even when we are happy and joyous, we always remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is why we come here to pray an additional prayer, a sixth prayer, to acknowledge the gifts of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to be grateful to Him for all His blessings. Some of it we recognize, and some of it, most of it, we don't recognize. وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. If you count the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will not be able to count it. So again, even in the day of happiness, we are still linked to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are still very grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And part of our gratefulness is what we gave before Eid prayer, Zakatul Fitr, a donation to Allah for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to reach the needy and the poor. Also, let me remind you that it is the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the tradition of the Prophet. When you come to Eid prayer, you use one way, and going back, use another way, another road. So there will be two witnesses on the day of judgment that you came to this congregation, that you answered the call of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These are the great blessings of this Eid. Let me remind you also, and remind myself, about fasting 6 days of Shawwal. These are important because the Prophet ﷺ said, if you fast the 30 days of Ramadan and then fast another 6 days of the month of Shawwal, it is as if you have fasted the whole year. One full year, the rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for fasting these days. So let's all enjoy the blessings of the month of Ramadan and learn from its lessons and enjoy this day of happiness and joy, and remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in every aspect of our life. I pray to Allah to accept our fasting, to accept our prayers, to accept our good deeds. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Allahumma ansuri al-Islam wal-Muslimin. Allahumma man arada bil-Islam wal-Muslimin khayran fawaffiqhu likulli khayr. ومن أراد بالإسلام والمسلمين شرا فخذه أخذ عزيز مقتدر. اللهم من أراد بالإسلام والمسلمين شرا فخذه أخذ عزيز مقتدر. اللهم من أراد بالإسلام والمسلمين شرا فخذه أخذ عزيز مقتدر. اللهم لا تدع لنا ذنبا إلا غفرته، ولا هما إلا فرجته، ولا عيبا إلا سترته، ولا حاجة لك فيها رضا إلا قضيتها يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اشف مرضانا، اللهم عاف مبتلانا، اللهم ارحم موتانا، اللهم اجعل الجنة مثواهم ومثوانا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم أغننا بحلالك عن حرامك، وبطاعتك عن معصيتك، وبك عمن سواك. اللهم اجعلنا من عتقاء شهرك الكريم. اللهم تقبل منا صلاتنا وصيامنا وصالح أعمالنا، وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين، وكل عام وأنتم بخير.